In this lesson 3, you are going to see what is the difference between raster files and vectorial files. Then we are going to download topographic raster maps for the province of Alberta. Also, we are going to be talking about raster files and their metadata. Then we are going to talk about GeoTIFF and TIFF format for the raster files. And then also we are going to see how works the coordinate reference systems in raster files. And also we are going to work with an Excel files and how we can plot the information at the Excel files in Quantum GIS. Then we are going to change the coordinate reference systems for our raster file using different tools, and also we are going to give georeferencing information to an image without any georeferencing information. The websites we are going to visit today, they are going to be National Topographic System Index Map, and also we are going to visit again GeoGratis.
Hello everybody! Today we are going to talk about raster files. In the lesson 1 and 2 we was working with vectorial files, okay? And now we are going to start to work with raster files. To start, let's go to do a simple explanation what is a raster files, okay? Just Google. Vector versus raster in GIS. Okay, that's a good example. Here is a vector and here is a raster, okay? In vector we have lines, we have points, and we have polygons. Also, I believe this picture is going to be bigger and better. We have point features, line features, and polygon features, right? But in raster we have an image. Okay, a picture. Okay, and this picture, the small unit, it's a pixel, right? We have columns and we have rows, okay, with the cells, and we have information in these pixels because the color is information, right? In this case, you can see the points we represent in a vectorial files. It's just a picture with a different color, okay? Happens the same here with the line, right? It represents a river. But in an image, we have pixels with different color. It allows us to do interpretations, okay? And here for the polygons, it's the same here. We have pixels with different colors, and they define an areas, okay? That's a very simple explanation, but at the moment it's enough, okay? Now we are going to create a new folder. We're going to call that one Lesson 3. We are going to download some files. First of all, that one is going to be the first link for today. This is a National Topographic System Index Map. Okay, we can go here and we are going to download a PDF. We have all these different options. Going to take PDF option. This is for the prayers. And that one is the resolution of the PDF. Here is a map of Alberta. We are going to download a topographic map of Edson. We're going to download this square. That one is going to be 83F9. Okay? Let's go to open this link. We was using this website at the lesson one to download some files, vectorial files, but today we are going to download raster files. Okay, as you can see here, raster maps and vectorial data. Okay, our option is going to be this one. There are a couple of different links. We are going to work with this one. You have here all the information about this file. GeoTIFF, okay? And here there are a couple of options. This one, it's about the scale. We are going to work, first of all, with 250K. And we say it was 83. It was 83F9. F. In this case, it's just one file because when the scale is 250K, it covers all this area. But if you use the other one, I mean the 50K, I'm going to show you. 50K, 83 F. You can see here the different numbers, right, for the F. Then for 250K, you are going to download all this area. But if you decided to download just 50K, it's going to be just this square, number 9, okay? That's going to be 250. Save. I can move that one. Okay, here. Also, it's going to create a new folder. It's going to be 250. Let's put inside. Strike here. And also, we are going to download the 50K. Number 9. Okay. That's an image, okay? You can see every point of that one, it's a pixel. It has information, right? In this case, we have rivers, we have contours. have here the city of Edson. Okay, every pixel has different kind of information. The scale, as you can see here, is 250k. And the information we have here, we have the UTM coordinates, as you can see here. Even we have the town, township, and also the degrees here. Okay, we have then three different kind of coordinate system, right? For the UTM, it is very important to check what is the datum and also the zone for the UTM. Okay, the zone, as you can see here, it's zone 11. And I'm looking for the datum. There we go, it's here. It's North American datum 1927. Transmecaro projection. For the other map, 50k. We have the same information here, but the scale is just 50k. The datum is the same. Okay. This file is a TIFF, and the projection is inside the file. If you can remember when we was talking about the vectorial files, you need an specific file. It was, I'm going to show you just to refresh. For example, for the city, we have the shape. Shape, and this one, it was for the coordinates. Okay, if you don't have that one, the file, it's not georeferencing. Okay, in this case, these files, the projection is inside the file. We don't need another extra file. Okay, and that one is already georeferencing. This file is the metadata. You can check here all the information related with the file. The code for the coordinate reference systems. Okay. Now let's go to open the Quantum GIS. And let's go to work, okay, with the map of 50k. To load any raster file, we have to click in this button, add raster layer. 50k is this one. Let's go to check what is the coordinates. In this case, we have NAT 83, UTM Zone 11 North. That's okay, because as we say before, that was 11, Zone 11, and the datum it's North American datum 1927, but in this case we have NAT 83. That's the information inside the file, okay? But if we go here, we place here, as you can see here at the bottom, the coordinates are no good for this point. Let's go to create a Excel file, and let's go to do an experiment. Put here number x UTM and YUTM. YUTM, let's go to put the coordinates. Number is going to be 0.1. The coordinates are for the X is 53.4000, for Y is 59.55000. Okay, when you want to open a Excel file with Quantum GIS, you have to make sure you keep the file, you save the file in this option. Okay, that's the type. Okay, and we are going to keep that one in the desk. Save. Yes, close this one. We have the file here. Let's go to open with Quantum. To add this kind of information, you have to click in this button. Sorry, in this button. Add the delimited test layer. Have to make sure this option is click. Look for the file. Is this one open? That one is good. That one is good. This one has to be also click. Okay. We have to select the coordinates for the layer we are going to add. As we check here, this layer is in this kind of coordinate reference systems. Let's go to choose the same. Okay. And as you can see here, the point for these coordinates is here. Okay. Let's go to change and let's go to add the layer, but we are going to change now the coordinates. Okay, that's good. Good. Okay, but now we are going to select this one. Okay, the one we have on the map. Okay, and you can see now, let's go to change the color. Red. Apply. You can see here this point. That's good, okay? And it's very well located. Then what it means, we have to change the coordinate systems for this map, okay? Because as you see here, that's North American Darun, 1927, but the file is georeferencing with the NAT83, okay? Let's go to reproject, okay? To do that one, just go to here, raster, projections, and we have to select the first option, reproject, okay? Then input file is going to be the file we have opened already, is this one. Outside, we have to put a different name. Let's go to name this one as a NAT27, and we have to keep in this type, okay, because that one is the one is going to keep the coordinate reference systems inside the file. Okay, save. And that's the origin one. What coordinate system has this file? Okay, the file has this information. Okay, and our goal is NAT27 for the 11 zone. Okay, and for the other parameters, we are going to leave like that. And okay. Okay, the process is already complete. Close, close. As you can see, any change, okay? Looks like they are in the same position, okay? But let's go to close this one, remove, because you know the information here in the one we created, you can see here is not 27, okay, now already. Then we can go here, project properties, and let's go to change this one here, apply. Not 27, like okay. And now, as you can see here, the coordinates you can set at the bottom of the screen. Okay, let me check here. Okay, let's go to close this one. Okay, and let's go to open Quantum GA again. Okay, and let's go to open the file we created. It was that one, not 27. Open. Let's go to check the coordinates now. Now the coordinates are perfect. You can see. Now the point is already, well, the map is already georeferencing with these coordinate systems that is the same as we see here. Now if we want to add the point as we had before, open. That's okay, that's okay, okay, okay. That one is going to be 27. Okay, you can see the point, it's perfect located. Now let's go to create other kind of a scenario. For example, we have a map, okay? But for example, this map is without coordinate systems. Let's go to make that one. Paint. Let's go to open a file. It doesn't matter, whatever. I'm going to use this one. Then save as this kind of type. Okay, go to put here no coordinate reference system. And to keep in this file, save, close. Is this one here? It looks like the same, right? But it doesn't have any coordinate reference systems inside the file. As you can see in this one, properties, that one is JPG, and this one is properties TIFF. Okay, let's go to open this one with Quantum. Okay. Load raster layer is going to be this one, no coordinate reference systems. When you try to open, because the file doesn't have any coordinate system, the software asks you what coordinate system do you want for this file. Okay, we are going to select this one just at the moment, but as you can see the coordinate systems, well, in order to make this one easier, let's go to open with NAT 27. Then in this way we can compare the coordinates as we did before. Okay, coordinate, this one, no coordinate reference systems, okay. NAT 27, open. Okay, as you can see here, we go here and you check the coordinates, it doesn't make any sense. because there is no coordinate systems. It happens, for example, when you have a map, then you scan this map and you want to use this map for a project, but that map, you know, it's a hard copy. When you scan, you have a digital copy, but that copy is not georeferencing. Then you have to give to this digital copy coordinate systems, right? That's the same case. Okay, for do that one, we have to just to add a plugin. In this case, you have to put here georef, is this one, georeferencer, GDAL, check the box, close, and now go to raster, georeferencer. Now the plugin is ready to use. Click here. At the layer you want to georeferencing is going to be this one, no coordinate reference systems. Open. Select the coordinates you want for this layer, is going to be this one, NAT27. Then click here and click on the point you want to georeferencing. In this case, it's going to be this one because we have the coordinates already here. Then put the X is going to be this one and the Y is going to be this one. 53, 4, 0, 0, 0. 59, 5, 5, 0, 0, 0. Okay, we have the pawn already here. We are going to do that one for the 4 points we have here with the coordinates. This one is going to be this point. We have already 4 corners, and then we have to go here, press here, start georeferencing. Okay, transformation type, we are going to use the first polynomial one for the method. That one is going to be good. The projection we want for this one is going to be NAT27 UTM zone 11 north. The file we are going to get at the end of the process is going to be this one with modify to NAT27 27. That's good. This type geotiff, because that one is going to keep the coordinate systems inside the file. And okay, play, press the button on this one again. Here says the geoprocessing was successful. I was thinking the layer is going to be at here, but they ask if you want to save the points, this file, but we don't need it. Okay, now we can add this layer, is that one. Open. You can see this one doesn't have coordinate systems, and the one we created, so to the layer, is this one. Okay, and this one has the coordinates here. But what happened, let me check one thing, that's the coordinates we give to the project. This one is the zone we have. Okay, that's good. Okay, then the coordinates has to be good. You can see here that now that's perfect. Then we have this copy already georeferencing. Okay, let's go to close this one. That's it for today, guys. I know there was a lot of files. Let's go to make a resume of this one. The first is the one we downloaded. Okay, that was already georeferencing, but it was in NAT 83. Then we reprojected to NAT 27. It was that one. Then we created a map without georeferencing, it was this one, and then we use this map to give coordinates, okay, to this one. Okay, that's the job we was doing today. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much. Today we are going to reproject raster layer, but we are going to do in a different way. I'm going to show you other way to do it. Okay. Then we are going to work with the 250k map. Okay. That's a hard copy. It was a scan. Okay. And now it's projected with even the map, it's North American data in 1927. The projection, as we saw the other day, is NAT 83. I'm going to show you 50k. That's this one. If you go here, as you can see here, that's NAT 83 UTM Sun 11. Okay. Now we are going to cancel. We are going to take note of these coordinates for every corner. This one. Here at the bottom also. Okay. And the last corner is going to be these coordinates. I take note already. And we are going to create an Excel. When you have to reproject a raster layer, you need at least 3 points, okay? Because 1 point, it represents just 1 point. 2 points, it represents a line. And 3 points, it represents a plan, right? But if you have 4 points, that's better. And you have to keep these points very far away, one from each other, right? That's the way you're going to have the better results. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 different points, and the coordinates is 4, 4. When you save the file, you have to do in a specific format. So to name that one as a book 2, and you have to select this kind of format. Okay. Save. No. Cancel. We have the file here. Let's go to add this file to Quantum GIS. But before to add this Excel with the 4 points, we are going to go here, project properties, and then here we are going to select what kind of coordinate reference systems we want. Okay, that's very important. For example, as we know, we have the Sun 11 North, and for the UTM we can use any of these three. Okay, it doesn't matter, you can use whatever you want. Okay, but in our case we are going to use NAT 27 because we projected the other one as a NAT 27, but you can select
these ones, even if you want, you know, that one is the most popular, WGS84, okay, you can use that one if you want, okay, it doesn't matter. I'm going to choose this one. Okay, now we can add the points. As we said, it's book 2. Make sure this box, this option is click already. Also this one, that one is good. Okay. Now we're going to select the coordinate systems again. We said it's not 27. Even here it's already selected, right? You have to click yes, okay? Because we did here at the beginning, right? Not 27, even we don't have to click this option. Okay, now we know these points, they are in that coordinate systems, in not 27, zone 11. Okay, selected not 27, UTM zone 11, north. Now we are going to this option, georeferencer. Then click here to add the layer you want to reproject it. It's going to be this one. Open. And now it's going to be very easy to do that one. Okay. We have this coordinate. Is this point mark here at the center? Then from map Cavanas, then you select this point. Clicking this point at the center. Okay. Next point. There are a lot of lines, you have to be careful. In this case is this point here at the middle. Then we have to select this point here. Okay. The next one. You know, as we said, the best way to georeferencing is with 4 points, and they have to be very far away from the other one, from each to the other, right? You can, it's not good if you put the 4 points here at the middle. The next one is going to be this here. Right there, okay. And the last one. Going to be this point here. Okay, then click here. This option is good. This option is good. The coordinate systems we want for this one, it's not 27. Okay, okay. Not 27. Okay, okay. Now we have to put the output raster. This one. Not 27. Sorry, I made a mistake. Not 27. Okay. Run the process. That's successful. Close here. We don't want to save this information. This guy, and now we are ready to add the map. Is that one not?
Now you can see the points because these layers on the top, you can move that one here at the top and you're going to see the points there. You can change the color to make the points visible. Apply, okay. The points there. Okay, and now this map is already georeferencing with NAT 27, okay? But as I said, you can do that one for any other kind of coordinate reference systems. Okay. Like NIGHT 83 or WGS 84, okay? It's the same process, okay? But I decided to do in NAT 27 because we have the 50K in NAT 27 and we are going to work now with both maps at the same time. Okay, that's it for this thing.